Welcome to Annie's Pink Chair. And I have a very special guest that is a fellow Minnesotan that I met a few years back. And she's just a beautiful human being. And she's done some groundbreaking work that a lot of us wish we could have done way back in the day. So my friend is Vednita Carter, and she's the founder of Breaking Free, one of the first nonprofit organizations based in St. Paul, Minnesota, and in the country, whose mission is to end all forms of prostitution and sex trafficking. Ms. Carter is also an author, sought-after speaker, trainer, and award-winning pioneer in the abolitionist movement. Vednita, how are you today? I'm so happy you came on our show today.
Thank you so much for having me. You're going to have to excuse my voice. I'm getting a little hoarse.
It's okay. It's just an honor. It's an honor to see your beautiful face. And I see your posts on Facebook. And girl, you have been doing this work for how many years now?
Just about 30.
Wow.
Just about 30 years.
So I want to honor your journey, because 30 years ago, I was in the sex industry still. Mm-hmm. And so you are like a mom to so many people. And what I love about you is, first of all, you're from Minnesota.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
And the other thing is that I did not know you were around when I needed help when I was in Las Vegas. I didn't know about Breaking Free and about that someone created a program to help girls like me and all my friends. So can you tell me about yourself and what actually got you into the sex industry and eventually being trafficked?
Yeah, well, what just even go back a little further than that. First off, I was raised by my grandmother and a Christian woman, very Christian woman. And so I was brought up to you know, in the church, I'm going to say church every Sunday, every Wednesday, you know, one of those type kids. But what really got me involved in this sex industry was that I after I graduated high school in the 70s, the stripping came to Minnesota, is what I'm going to say. And that was early 70s. And so I just graduated from high school, and myself and a girlfriend decided, based on an ad we saw in the newspaper, make $1,000 a week or more dancing.
Right.
And we thought, wow, a good way to get money for school, for college.
Was it party time?
Yes, or was it.
Girl, you already know. I worked for Party Time too. I'll say so. They were like, and Virgil, was he the owner back then still?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my goodness. Yes. So that's, you know, I'm taking it back quite right when they first came.
I know.
And so they said dancing, and you know, we were pretty naive. We really did think it was dancing. We thought,
right,
something we haven't done before. Why not? So we went for the interview. The interview was totally cool. You know what I mean? We were fully dressed. We danced and we got hired and we were all excited.
Wait a minute. What kind of interview was it? Did they bring you into the office, like the back office with the booker lady, or did you have to go on a stage?
No, we went in a back office where we just talked to him and some other person. I didn't see a
Did you feel like Virgil, and rest his soul because he's no longer here, did you feel like he was being exploitive at all or kind of weird with you guys or not?
You know, no, I really didn't at that time. You know, it just seemed like he talked to us about becoming models and, you know, things like that eventually. And